When I was at uni, I would always play this free online game during commutes called Unblock That. All you have to do is free the red block from the board in as few moves as possible. Now, I haven't played the game since, but I thought it might be quite a fun challenge to teach my computer how to play it. So in this video, I'm going to show you how I made an AI bot in Java which beats this game using the A-star algorithm. Projects like this are great to show recruiters that you not only understand the concepts in theory, but are able to apply that knowledge to find solutions. You can find all the code on my GitHub. It's pretty simple. There's 6 classes, each with 4 to 5 methods. I have a to-do list. Let's get started. If you don't know about pathfinding algorithms, I have a playlist where I explain them, which I'll link in the description. The first thing we have to do is model the game, which is easy enough because it's just a board with blocks on it. Each board object will have a hash map of blocks. Each block will have an ID, the X and Y coordinates for the first square, and a length. Next, we need to find the arrangement of blocks on the board and store that information. How we can do this is, for each column, check the colour of the pixels in these little in-between sections and see if it's close to the block colour. Because the blocks aren't one uniform colour, we can just test if it's lighter than the dark background. If it is, we create a block and set its X and Y value. If we go to the next pixel and it's also a light colour, we know it's a 3-piece block and we just need to update the block length. Moving column by column will allow us to find all the vertical blocks. After that, we'll want to find all the horizontal blocks. These two blocks have different behaviours, so let's make them into 2 subclasses. And we'll make the block parent class abstract. Now, before we can search for the blocks, we need to know the pixel coordinates of these areas. In the last video, we built a simple class which can help us here. Simply, this class presents a transparent window which, when clicked, will output the pixel's X and Y coordinates as well as its RGB value. Okay, now that we have all our coordinates, in our main method, let's create a robot. Next, we don't want our program to run until the game is full screen. We can do this by checking if a pixel in the top left is this brown colour. Now we'll create the main loop. Once the program is complete, we'll want this to run for as many levels as the game has. And the first thing we'll do is create a new board and pass it to a method which will discover the blocks. We also need to know which block is the red one, so we'll store its key in the board as well. Now I'm going to add a few useful methods to board and block. In block, we'll add a method to test if it covers a certain square. We can make it abstract in the parent class and then give both subclasses their unique implementations. In the board class, we'll add methods to test if a square is occupied, and one to print the board's state to the console. So let's quickly test our code is working. Okay, now we need to find the shortest possible sequence of moves to free the red block. So let this node represent the initial state of the board. There are X number of possible moves we can make, which will bring us to these new board states. We are looking for a very specific board state, which is where the red block is sitting here. And we can do that using the A-star algorithm. And here's the pseudocode on the left. Now I'm going to implement it in our program. I'll just need to add a few more variables to board. A method for detecting the goal state, and I need a heuristic function. What I'll use is the number of blocks which are obstructing the red block's path to the exit plus 1. As you may well know, a heuristic function cannot underestimate the cost of reaching a goal state. And if there are x number of blocks in the way, it will take at least x number of moves to get them out of the way, and one additional move to get the red block to the exit. We also need a method which returns the neighbouring board states. To do that, each block must be able to detect moves it can legally make, then return copies of the current board with those moves. We'll also need to store whatever that move was in the board, so later on we can retrace our steps. To make copies of these boards, we'll add a copy constructor to the board class, and override the clone method in the block class and its children. Then, in the board class, we'll add a method to return all these new boards. At one point in the algorithm, we have to check if two boards are equal to each other, so let's override the equals method in the board and the block. Now, once a path has been found, we need to return all the moves that took us from the beginning state to the goal state. These can then be passed to the makeMoves method, which will call each of the moves in turn using the robot. Once that's done, all that's left to do is to make sure the next level button is pressed. Now we'll just update the for loop so it runs for 120 levels, and let's run it. There you go.